600 street gangs, maybe about 12 of those are really hardcore gangs. We have, that's the headquarters of the Mexican army, which you hear about here, the Texas Mexican mafia. In Austin, we have the Latin Kings, the Texas Syndicate. In Waco, we have the Unified Boys. In our Austin division, we have the first prison gang that we believe is going to become the first major international prison gang. That's the Barrio Azteca. Basically, San Antonio, we've been tracking gangs since about 1986.
So this is safe to say that. Another question for you is, what groups did you have?
First visit, we went through the initial interview. Midway through the interview, I asked him, "Are you resident of the gang. You need to be aware of all these things before you hit the field.
Okay. You have a good start in terms of knowing your offenders, knowing the culture. I think we have a few minutes left. I'm going to ask you to tell the folks that story.
Well, it was during a case that we got out of the case that we could send it during a basic
incident. So we have a case
that we can send it during a cruising this point, I ran into a Texas syndicate camp that I had under supervision with some of his bodyguards. And as I stood there talking to him, my wife sat down on a park bench, and she was surrounded by his bodyguards. And normally, you might think, well, this is a terrible situation. But actually, it was a sign of respect. Kind of, even when I was talking to their boss, they were kind of guarding my wife. So that's the way I interpreted it. But you also need to be familiar with it, with the culture of the gang, per se. And again, all the gangs have different cultures.
I've heard the story a couple times, and I wanted our guests to hear it. I think it's a fascinating lesson. Again, knowing who you're dealing with. Rachel, I'm going to give you the opportunity to have the last word on this topic.
Well, I would just add, we'll bring in a couple.
because they used to have females in prison gangs. And then there's a gender that kind of acts as auxiliaries. They have an assistant woman in the front and the girls carrying messages back and forth in and out of the institutional setting. But by and large, they're not allowed to be members of the gang.
Okay.
So that's prison gangs. So that's just prison gangs.
Facts in the original PSI document, not
just